I really appreciate you all for being here. I'm Sarah Eckhart. I'm the Travis County Judge. I brought you all here to announce that I have asked Senator Wendy Davis to lead a sexual assault prevention and healing work group for Travis County. We all recognize in our community that we need to do more to prevent sexual assault, to prosecute sexual assault, and also to heal from sexual assault. I think we also recognize that the public discourse of late has been acrimonious at times. And we can get to a place of healing, I believe. I think that we can speed the weeding out of sexual assault from our community together much more quickly than if we're divided. We recognize that the act of sexual assault is a visceral violation of self, that the violator physically asserts that the victim does not deserve dominion over her own body, isn't allowed to set her own limits. And healing from this dehumanizing act is a deeply personal mission. But we also recognize that preventing, holding accountable, and assisting in the healing is a responsibility of the community as a whole. So as a first step, I am asking the Sexual Assault Prevention and Healing Workgroup to focus on the standardization for the collection, aggregating, and analysis of meaningful data on how reported sexual assault is addressed in the criminal justice context. But this is just a first step, and I'm not suggesting that we should ever end there. We must not end there because we know that most sexual assault is not reported to law enforcement. So I'm asking that the Sexual Assault Prevention and Healing Workgroup also further convene discussions exploring and expanding resources available to victims of sexual assault, whether or not their incident was reported to or is being addressed in the criminal context. This is a deeply personal mission for all of us, but it's also a community mission that we must continue. I want to send out my deepest and sincerest gratitude to all of the public servants who've been working in this space and dedicating much of their careers to preventing, holding accountable, prosecuting, and helping victims heal from sexual assault. And I also want to send out my sincerest gratitude to the advocates and to the victims of sexual assault who are living in that balance between a deeply personal wound and a willingness to work in the public and community sphere to prevent that wounding from ever happening to someone else. So my thanks go out to Senator Davis for her willingness to take on this charge. And with that, I'd like to invite her up to the podium to speak with you.
Thank you, Judge. Just Wendy now, no more Senator. I am Wendy Davis, and I was very proud as a member of the Texas Senate from 2009 to 2014 to place as a prominent part of my work survivors across the state of Texas. I start from a position of believing survivors and believing that they deserve healing in every way that we can offer to them as a community, particularly as we offer it through the criminal justice system. It's for that reason that in 2011, I asked for an audit of the backlog of rape kits in our state, a backlog that revealed that we had approximately 20,000 untested kits sitting on evidence room shelves across this state. I also worked very hard, along with other members of the Texas Senate and House, to secure funding to begin the testing of that backlog. There's been a great deal of work done since then at the state level, and the nonprofit that I lead, Deeds Not Words, and the advocates who work through the training of our nonprofit have been an important part of helping to bring forward suggested legislation to continue to make sure that survivors of sexual assault, male and female, in our state receive the justice that they deserve. I think we all who live here in the city of Austin and the county of Travis would agree that we have some work to do in our own backyard. And it's that work to do in our own backyard that has motivated me to want to be a part of helping to make sure that we're doing everything we can to bring all voices to the table and to provide the kind of support that is needed for those who are survivors of sexual assault. From the moment someone comes into our system until the end of their prosecution, we want to know that we have handled their cases as they should be handled. And that even for those who make a decision not to be a part of a criminal justice response, that we're providing the kind of community response that is needed. This kind of conversation means that every person who has an interest in bringing healing to survivors of sexual assault should be part of the conversation. Survivors themselves, the advocacy groups that work so very hard to make sure that their voices are heard and that their cases are appropriately handled, social service organizations that provide mental and medical supports, the criminal justice system itself, whether at the city, county, and state level, all are an important part of a conversation that creates a system of support and a surrounding of care for those who are survivors of assault. I do want to make it clear that anyone who comes forward believing that their case, their violation, was not handled as it should have been and as it could have been, is someone who is bringing forward legitimate concern to be heard and addressed. I know the city is working quite hard on bringing forward a resolution on Thursday that will help to address the city's response to legitimate concerns that have been brought forward. I do believe we begin at a place where we consider those concerns legitimate, and we do our part to make sure that we're providing a system going forward that will bring some meaning to experiences that weren't handled as they should have been, so that we learn how to do better in the future, and we represent ourselves as a community model of what other cities, other counties, and other states should do. I'm very happy to be a part of this, and I thank Judge Eckert for asking me to. Thank you, Judge.
I also want to acknowledge Commissioner Gomez joining us here today with all of her support so generously, and also Kelly White of Safe Alliance. Just incredible work. You all provide the backbone for medical attention, psychological assistance, actual housing and transition services for individuals who've experienced sexual assault and also family violence. I cannot thank Safe Alliance enough for the tremendous work that you have been engaged in for literally decades in our community. Thank you so very much to you and Ms. Spann for your tremendous work. I perceived a need for a group to be convened, a place, a table to be convened that was not prosecution, that was not law enforcement, that was not advocacy group, that was a neutral convener to hear all of the concerns, and also to bring in some voices that we haven't heard from at all at this point. I think that it's important for us to have that neutral convener, and I believed that that Wendy Davis was the right person to convene that table and to elevate it to the to the level it really deserves. You're seeing it formed right here in front of your eyes. I would suggest that the very first tangible, what you will see initially is at the City Public Safety Commission hearing on February 4th, there's going to be some very good work done and some good information laid out. And I think that that will be a early and continuing building of trust and convening of necessary stakeholders, would you say?
Yes, I don't know. I know what I don't know. Let me start by saying that. And it's my intention to speak to as many people as I possibly can, the SART particularly, those who have been working much longer than I have at the local level on the issues that confront this community and how we best handle them. From survivors themselves, as I said, to the advocate services for them, to medical and social support services, to everyone up and down the criminal justice chain. I believe all of their voices are a necessary part of putting together what's broken so that we can begin the process of healing and moving forward in a way that is comprehensive. And that includes perspectives from every level. So I can't answer for you how many people will that be. I'm just beginning the work of making sure I have a full depth and breadth of understanding of exactly who has already, in great detail and with great effort and passion, been working on this effort here, and that they continue to be included and uplifted as an incredibly important part of this process.
What are we healing from?
I think anyone who's paid attention to what's been happening across the country, in this state, and at the county and city level here, recognizes that we have not been doing our best by survivors of sexual assault. And when I talk about healing, I think of it from a number of different aspects. One, from start to finish, when a survivor comes forward with a complaint about what's happened to him or her, that person is received well, and that from that moment is surrounded by the very best practices in how we as a community surround that person with the support that they need. I also know that there are a number of people in this city, in this county, in this state, and across this country, who are survivors of sexual assault, who do not come forward in the criminal justice system. And the judge has certainly expressed to me her very firm conviction in making sure that we create space and place and support for those survivors as well. So I'm thinking of this very holistically, but I, again, know enough to know that there's so much I don't know. And I look forward to hearing your perspective on what healing ought to include and making sure that we're bringing that forward as part of this process.
You mentioned best practices, and I just want to make sure that the SART has been around for the longest, I think.
Yes.
Doing the most holistic work.
Absolutely.
The DA has broken away from the SART and
yes. Yeah.
Essentially trying to do the same thing.
Yeah.
With the DA's ISAT, with the SART, with this resolution, with the third party audit, with now this.
Yes.
I'm trying to understand how is this helping when you talk about holistically? It seems like there are multiple groups popping up, all trying to do the same thing.
I hope to try to bring all of that together. And maybe that is a task that some might consider impossible. I've always believed that our best work is done when we set aside disagreements about who ought to be doing it, and we come together and we do it collectively. The SART has been doing spectacular work, and that work ought to be lifted in front of and at the forefront of helping to guide our efforts going forward. And I intend to make sure that their voices hopefully are reunited with the voices of some who have segmented, are brought together. Because I truly believe that only when all of those voices are at the table will we have the kind of conversation and therefore the outcome that I know we all want to see. I'm going to have a lot of conversations with a lot of people before, and it won't be my recommendations. It's my hope that it will be the recommendation of the whole. A whole meaning the group that we have helped to bring together.
Also, I'd like to chime in on that. Yep. I do think it's important for our community to get beyond acronyms, whether it's SART, whether it's ISAT, whether it's any other acronym. What we have here is a need to address one of the most insidious crimes that can occur against another person. And so I am not looking to Wendy Davis to burnish the responsibility, reputation, or position of any particular acronym. The acronyms are unimportant. It's the work that's important. And so I want to focus on the work. I think that part of what we are struggling with right now is a myopic, in my view, I'm simply speaking my opinion, a myopic concentration on who rather than the what. And so we do have SAFE here as well. We have our sheriff's department, our prosecution, our law enforcement, our mental health community, our medical community, as well as the victims themselves, are involved in a mission that's going to take a long time. We've done some tremendous work over the years. We have a lot more work to do. I think that if we focus on which table rather than who's at the table and the work that's getting done, I think that we will stay in a place that is less productive.
Yes. Two more questions.
I'm curious on it too. Like, are you setting a new table and asking everyone to come to the table who has maybe moved to different sets?
What I'm asking is that we stop moving to different sides. What I'm asking is...
That happens when you create multiple groups, it creates... That's what I'm saying, because I'm in agreement with you. Mm-hmm. I think that we should have everyone at one table, and that's the most comprehensive way that we're going to be able to get good data, which I think is one of the main goals of everybody, is we're getting the right data so we have the right numbers working off of to be able to start beginning to do this kind of work.
So let's focus...
multiple groups doing different things, I wonder...
That's a great way to look at this. So let's take a specific what. Like I said, I'd like to get away from the who, and let's get to the what. So one of the, what I've asked to be the first deliverable out of this group is there has been a early recognition by, I think, everyone. Now, I think it's everyone, that we need to have a much higher standard for the collection, the aggregating, and the analysis of the data for cases that are reported to law enforcement and how they're treated in the criminal justice context. So, law enforcement, prosecution, and the advocacy groups that are involved in the SANE exams have come together, at least initially, to create a first draft of what that should look like. And now, broader advocacy community, as well as the victims themselves, need to be brought in on that conversation for how that looks going forward. I think that that's an extremely important what. And I think that we need a neutral convener for that discussion. I don't perceive that the current construct is a place where all parties feel they can be heard.